哎，各位新老观众，各位朋友哈，大家好！大家一看到这张照片呢，好多人都认出来了啊。这地儿呢，就是纽约市皇后区法拉盛的那个缅街啊，Main Street。咱们说啊，很多啊，那个游客呀，或者说很多人啊，就是说来法拉盛，奔的是什么呢？就是奔那口什么呢？就是吃的。因为这个地儿啊，咱们说啊，是聚集了中国各种各样的，咱们说呢，天南地北啊，有这种各种传统的这种美食。包括我们北京的这个片皮鸭，对不对啊？北京烤鸭、天津狗不理的包子也曾经火过一阵儿啊。包括武汉的热干面啊，咱们说广东的菜系都有啊。但是咱们说啊，这些东西啊，这些地儿啊，能撑过啊20年经营的，那就很少很少了。基本上有的呢，开个3、5年就关张了啊，关了开，开了关啊，就是这样。所以你要说这边呢，这些华人店里有没有说一些百年老店呢？基本上是没有的。哎，可是你要说呢，这个整个这个纽约市这个法拉盛地区有没有百年的这种口碑特别硬的，像我们中国那叫百年老字号的，那有没有？那还真有，我跟您说，那就是这家了哈，啊。咱们说呢，乐平肉食店，这是一家德国移民开的啊，这是他家的铺子，看着有点小，有点不起眼，可是我要告诉您，这个店是1921年开的，到今年已经是101年了。哎，咱们说呢，这家人呢，可以说呢是好几代的传承啊。那具体怎么样呢？哎，咱们呢一会儿再聊。各位啊，咱们回来啊，这个你们看到呢，就是这个来平老先生他们一家。现在呢，咱们说呢，这个家主权呢转到了他家的这个壮啊，老壮。大伙儿都说老壮长得像这个雷神啊，确实挺像的。但是老壮啊，人特别的好啊，他跟我呢也是挺有交情的。你看到他们家这个老的这个，咱们说肉食店还保持着他开门时候的样子，好多里面的这种咱们说卖的这个酱品啊，非常好吃，一般市面啊你还找不着。咱们说呢，这都得归功呢，咱们这个来平老爷爷啊，当年呢是他开创的这个肉铺啊。你可以看到呢，他家可以卖的这种，咱们说呢，包括热狗、汉堡，有150多个花样啊，非常非常的多啊。另外呢，你这是他家的这个厨房的一个面，你看看各种各样的刀啊，各种各样的这个制这香肠的香肠机，这些东西都是老古董了，任何一件拉出去，这都是能卖不少钱的。你包括他家锯这个牛骨的锯啊，这都是一应俱全，这是根本不容易见的。这老店铺，这后面呢，他家就是呢这个大块的肉的处理的这个地方，前面呢是他的门面。每年啊，我跟大家说啊，一到这圣诞节和感恩节啊，我们家要去买这个小羊排骨，一定是来平他们这个帝国市场这家买。他们家这个肉又新鲜又嫩，不信您可以试试。我这一边跟你解说，我嘴上这个口水都有点往下流，真是好吃，而且还不贵。他家各种各样的香肠，各种各样的熏肉，那是一应尽有，一应尽有。哎，包括我最喜欢吃他们家的这个肠儿，这个肠儿呢就是做热狗吃，特别的好吃。每天这个肉啊，基本上到晚上基本都能卖完。所以说啊，要去啊，4点之前一定要去。那人家说你这说了半天了，是不是你这话作数呢？我说呢，我这是一家之言。咱们现在上网看一看呢。他这家店在网上的风评又是怎么样的？随后咱们到他的店里面，我今天带大家呢亲自感受一下这里面的气氛和文化。各位哈，现在呢带大家呢，咱们到这个 Yelp 的这个主页去看看这家帝国啊，这个肉品店又叫帝国市场，你看看它的评分啊，风评是怎么样的？你可以看到啊，中文翻译过来就是这个叫做帝国市场啊。英文呢，就是 Empire Market 啊，因为有些观众呢，可能还是需要看这个中文的翻译，所以咱们呢就先把这个网页呢设定为中文啊，以让大家呢好来呢就是看这方面信息啊。咱们说呢，这个就是它的地址了啊，1426这个大学点 College Point 啊。其实啊，这个 College Point 大学点自己本身是一个城市，它和法拉盛不是连在一起的。 好多人觉得说这个大学点是这个法拉盛的一部分，其实这个认知是完全错误的。大学点是大学点城，它和法拉盛是两个镇子啊，不要以为是一个镇子啊。很多住在法拉盛的人，他们不是像我这儿的历史专门研究历史的这种学者，或者说呢，你不是本地人，这个就是说事实，很少有人知道这个大学点它自己是一个镇子，它和法拉盛不是一回事儿啊，跟大家说一下。你可以看得到呢，基本上的风评呢都是顶级的五星啊，而且也不贵，确实不贵。而且呢，他们家做的这个德国香肠是特别好吃，我和我太太都特别爱吃他们家做的这个东西，而且这个东西很难得啊。他们呢就是周日和周一关闭，其他时间的都开门啊。你可以看到啊，给的这个评论一水的都是五星啊。我们看看大家说什么哈。你们可以看得到哈，就是说，包括我的那个老朋友壮哈，说他长得像雷神，他长得确实挺帅的，壮哈，昨天跟他一块聊了聊，他家的这个肉啊，基本上每天啊是绝对能卖完的，就是香肠是绝对卖完的。有的时候你来晚了，像我昨天我都去晚了，你可以看到对他的这个服务什么都特别满意，而且最主要的这个地方保持着他在1921年开业的时候。那会儿的经典的美国这种街边老店的这个就是说它的这个样貌，就是店的前半边呢是卖糖果的，后半边呢是卖肉的。现在已经很少能找到就是这种还存活着的这种老的纽约式商店了，真的是不容易。而且他家的这巧克力饼干是手工制的，特别好吃。每年到这个圣诞节我都得去他们家买一次巧克力饼干去，真的是特别好。招待我的朋友，因为边上我很多朋友是这个白人嘛。所以说呢，这个巧克力饼干呢，有人做得好，有人做得不好。但是他们家这个 Empire Market， 他们家的巧克力是非常受欢迎的。好，大家你们都可以看得到哈，风评都是非常不错。你看很多甚至中国人呢也去买的哈，这一看这就是个中国人哈。你看看都是拿这个中国的，哎，你看呢拿着中国酱，确实好吃。他们家的香肠，嗯。好吧，这个就是给大家呢，咱们看一看他们家的这个风评啊，你看看这风评都是相当好的啊，都是相当好的。所以说呢，如果大家你想去呢，就是这个就是地址了哈，1426这个 Collins Point Boulevard。我建议你们呢，如果要从这个法拉盛出发呢，你们可以坐这个65号这个 bus 啊，这565号公交车，大概从法拉盛缅街7号线开过去的话。不堵车，20分钟、30分钟就到了啊，非常容易找啊，非常容易找。好吧，现在咱们回到现场，给大家看一看昨天我的录像。好，咱们现在。
It is very hard to find a store like yours. So amazing, you know.
You know, New York City used to have so many, and now
so many things disappeared.
So gone, man.
I'm glad your store is still here.
When I was a kid, there was butcher shops all over the boulevard. You had the Italian guy, you had the German guy, we were the German guys, but they were all closed, man.
We used to have a German town here.
Yeah. used to be old German.
Yeah, purple hose and
1985.
And
the Metro card came and opened.
Yeah, the Metro cars in 1995.
But before that, it was a two fare zone. So if you worked in Manhattan, you lived. You had to pay for the bus and the subway.
That's right.
So nobody wanted to live out here.
Yeah.
It pushed you twice as much to get to work. Then when the one fare zone came out with the Metro card, we just exploded like New York City. I love it, man. It was great.
Yeah, it's because of the Metro cars up here at that time. Yeah. Yeah, but look at your store. It's still very, very, very family style. Very nice.
Original register from 1924.
Wow, this is really,
still
really.
Works, man. Look.
There are not too many labs. Wow, this not too many. You know, not too many machines still remain. You know.
You know what's crazy? If you can add up on it, but it maxes out at $3.99.
Oh, $3.99.
Yeah.
So how about if over $3.99?
Well, that's why we just leave it open.
Oh.
$3.99, we can get through anything now.
Yeah, you know, as far as I know, my friend, the last, you know, this kind of cashier machine repair factory in the Manhattan, they closed.
Oh my gosh.
2 weeks ago.
No kidding.
Yeah, they closed.
Well, I mean, this thing,
Before they close, you know, if you got some trouble for a machine, you can bring that. They have all kind of the unit for the change or something.
Isn't but
because the owner is too old, almost 90 years old,
well,
and his generation taking over the place, and
who's gonna take
not
over?
Too many business or something. So at the first, they just say on their website, say temporarily closed, and now it's say closed.
Wow.
I feel regardless, like I never have a chance to be there and making video today. But I'm glad I come here today and making video. Yeah, I know you have more than 15 kinds of, you know, the home kind of recipe for burgers.
Oh,
so, yeah.
Thank you so much, thanks.
Yeah, you have. You, and
you know what it is with the. We brought it down to all the most popular sellers.
Yeah, because many of our history. I mean, historical members, they're talking about like your childhood. They say we go to the Empire for our, you know, the weekend shopping. And I know you're close.
Are we candies or what?
And those candies are the best memorials.
We know kids for, we know
your place used to be the
we know the grandparents, all because they would come in and buy candy.
Yeah, the candy. Yeah, all those candy used to be very favorite.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But even these kids are coming here buy candy, don't even know it's a butcher shop.
But yeah, that's what they say,
candy. They leave, and then there's adults that come in and don't even realize that we have candy. Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah, you have, wow, that's the very originally your stores, you know. That's why we call it grocery store. Mm-hmm. We sell candy, we sell canned food, we have our butcher.
Everything you need.
Yeah, everything you need.
That's
and that's what's the old town life story.
Sure.
Just like you're talking to another gentleman here, you know, this is what the. What did the neighborhood be called?
Because, you know, I always feel like those stores are like the center of the community.
Yeah, the center of the community.
Because, I mean, even though I got the people coming here like, oh, did you see my kid? My kid went that way. Oh, did you see
exactly,
my mom?
Yeah, your
like,
mom, your
nice.
Bra, yeah.
And kids always know that if they have any trouble, they can run in here and we give them help now.
Yeah.
It's like a little safe spot. Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, and you have a lot of, you know, the amazing stuff still remain here, yeah.
Almost everything on that side of the store was given to us by customers.
Yeah.
People thought, oh, John, I found a pig, and they bring it in and give it to us. It's cool. We had the original tin ceiling.
Yeah, the tin ceiling, yeah.
And this deli case is from 1953, still runs.
Well, yeah, that's old fashioned. I only source this kind, the meat market, you know, in the East Village, Manhattan.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know there, right?
Yeah.
For Ukraine, that's Ukraine people's store. Yeah.
Yeah, there was even a Hungarian guy down there.
Yeah.
Forever. He closed a couple years ago.
Yeah, and it's called the East Meat Market in Manhattan. Yeah, but yours is. No, theirs, I think yours is better than theirs.
Thank you.
You have a lot of decorations and a lot of things, you know, I see. Still remain in the period of in the 1960, 1970, something even till you cannot find on the market today.
Like these things, they've been here forever.
Even till your
this is from the 70s up here.
Yeah, it's 70 productions. Yeah, especially that hot dog, you know. Yeah. that's the thing. Wow, yeah, that's the thing for collectible.
That has been there
you know.
So long.
Yeah, those things. Yeah, those things are you can get a very good price if you know. In the collection market, you know. Yeah, and you know your papers hanger, you know, the New York 1515.
This thing here?
Yeah.
This, and then this thing over here, are the two oldest things in the store.
Oh,
That's where they used to put, you put like a lamb, like,
oh, a lamb.
I'm gonna use my arm, but you put it there and you go like this.
Oh.
So it holds it.
Oh,
but
it's
this is probably the oldest thing in the store, man.
Whoa, man, you really have something amazing there. Wow, I only hear those things in the textbook, but never saw. I only saw some photos,
yeah.
But I really want to know what like you tell me, I know how it works.
Sure.
Yeah, I really have a very amazing story.
The things we have have been forever.
Yeah, you got everything. This is great. Yeah, I will be here next April for your store's 102 years.
We didn't even get to celebrate 100, so we're going to make sure 102 is good. Because with COVID and everything.
Yeah, the pandemic really, now is bad.
The pandemic got everybody off schedule. But yeah, man, 102, we're going to have a party.
好，各位观众哈，到现在为止呢，咱们这期节目就结束了。这是我纽约景点探秘的节目，我是纽约市的官方导游员王颖 Hermit。也感谢大家呢，在这个咱们说平台上呢观看我的节目。也希望呢，如果您感兴趣呢，您也可以呢以后加入我们的实地的这个咱们说旅游。不管怎么样呢，都感谢大家啊！不管呢您是新来的观众呢，还是以前就关注我的这个老观众。都感谢各位朋友，我们在 YouTube、哔哩哔哩和新瓜视频上呢，都在更新我们的这种就是说节目。如果您喜欢呢，就请您订阅、关注、点赞、分享。您有任何的意见，或者说呢，您有什么还想了解的，或者说呢，您有什么您想看的东西，您也可以呢把您的意见呢发在这个弹幕或者意见栏上。不管怎么样呢，都感谢呢新老朋友呢一如既往的这个支持啊，你们的支持呢就是对我最大的动力。那么好吧，咱们就是。下期节目呢，咱们再见了。